In this video on how to learn Scratch, we'll be looking at lists and how we loop through lists. So we're looking at lists, how we order a list, and how we would loop through a list. Part 1, we'll create the list and find the lowest element. Part 2, we will create an ordered list. So we use a loop inside another loop. Here is part 1. In this video, we'll be looking at lists. So if you go to data, you have make a variable and make a list. So you click make a list and then give the list a name. Here we're going to call this colors, and we're going to have a series of colors. So we can type them in. So we have red, purple, white. Doesn't matter what colors they are. In the end, we will order these colors. But for now, let's just enter them in. You can see them. We're going to start off with about 7 colors. So now we've typed them in, that's our list. So we want to do things with the list. So let's have a look at the blocks that we might use. So we want to go through each item in a list. Is a common task in programming. So we want to repeat. How many times do we want to go through and loop through the list? Well, that's going to be the amount of how many items there are, which is 7. So we can use the block length of. So we have length of colors. So we repeat that amount of time. We're going to use a count. So we've created a variable called count. We're going to set that to 1. And now we're going to go through the list and we're going to say what item is the list at the number the count's at. So we have 7 items. We want to go through item 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And we want to say which color is in that position. So when green flag is clicked, we're going to start the number off, count at 1, and then we're going to go through the list, loop 7 times, and on the first time it's going to say the first item, and then the second item, then the third up to the 7th. So we're going to add the count as well so you can see the number. So let's have a look at that when we run it. So we start off number 1, counts number 1, and the item is red. Number 2, the item is purple. Number 3, the item is white. Number 4, the item is green. 5 is blue. 6 is orange, and 7 is yellow. So we loop through the list, and we loop through it 7 times because that's the length, that's how many items are in a list. So that's very common in programming. So let's start off with some tasks. The first task is we're going to find the first color, meaning if we were going to put them in order, which one's the first, alphabetically the first. So the one that's going to start off with A, B, C, etc. So let's just the first one, which is the one that would be first if we put them in order. So we've created a variable called first color, and now we want to go through our loop, and when we find something that's going to be less than that first color, then we're going to change it. So the idea is that we get the first color, which is red, and we call that the first color. Then we check purple. Now if purple is before red, we then change the first color to purple, the variable first color. So then we go through white, green, blue, orange, and yellow. So we're going to compare each item with the variable first color to see which one should be first. So we start off with red, and then inside the loop we're going to check. We're going to check to see if the item in that position is less than what we've already got as first color. If it is, we then change first color to the item. So let's put that in an if statement, which is the control block. So we check our if part, and if that's true, we need to set the first color to the item that we're at. So let's duplicate that block and put that in. So if you're not too sure what these are doing, then once we run the program, you'll have more idea. So if we show you what the first color is when we go through the loop, that might help to show you what's happening. So we can see first color. So it's going to go through half a second on each time the cat says something. So let's look at what's going on. So number one, red. Number two, purple. You can see the first color at the moment is purple. Then it's gone to green, and now it's gone to blue. Orange and yellow aren't before blue, so it stayed at blue. So we go through all the colors, and the first color is going to remain the same until it finds something that's less than that color. And then when it does, it swaps. And by the time we get to the end of the list, we have the first color. We want the list of colors in order. So in this example, we're going to create a new list, which is going to be ordered. So we're going to name that ordered colors. Let's move that so you can see it. And we want to move the colors from the first color to the second onwards, from colors to ordered colors. And what we need to think about is, when we find the first color, we can move it to the second list and remove it from the first list. So we start off inserting the first color from colors into ordered colors. So we're going to loop through all the colors, find the first one, which is blue. So we can do that. We've done that already with the blocks. And then we move it into ordered colors. So now we need to think about removing blue from colors list. So we're going to delete blue from colors. But we do that using the number. So it's the fifth item in the list. So we need the number 5 to say that's the item in the list that we need to delete. So we're going to create a variable. And this we're going to call where first. So we're going to set where first at 1. And then if we find a color that's lower than the first one, we're going to change that variable to the number of the item in the color. So we'll go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And where first, in the example with blue, will equal number 5. And then once we've finished the loop, we can delete that element number 5 in the list. So we can have a look at that. So we start off. Well, we need to empty ordered colors when we start. So in Scratch, the values remain from the last time it runs. So we need to delete from ordered colors. Right now when we run that, we can go through the colors, and remember the first color we'll check each time, and the answer is blue. You can see where first equals 5. So now we've put blue in ordered colors, and number 5 blue has disappeared. So now instead of having 7 items in a list, we have 6. One of the problems we can see is that at the beginning of our program, the value blue has been removed from colors from the last time the program ran. So unfortunately, we can't just create the list colors. We need to make sure that all of the elements in the colors are created every time the program runs. So we can do that by deleting all of the items in the colors and then adding each color to the list to start off with. So we can add the red, purple, white, green, blue, orange and yellow, and we need to make sure we need to delete what exists first. So this way we set up both the colors and the ordered colors list, both lists, before we start. So that's a slight difference we have in Scratch than we may have in other programming languages, but in this case we need to do that for the program to work. So when we run that, you can see now that the value blue is back in our colors list. So we need to do that for the program to work properly and to work properly in this example. So now we can just go through the list as we did before. Okay, we want our ordered colors to include all of the colors. So at the moment we find the first color, we move that and we remove it from colors. So that works when we have the seven colors. Now we want to do that when there's six colors and 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So we're going to loop again using the repeat block, and we're going to use the length of the colors. While that's going to reduce, we're going to do that and we're going to run the same code over again just inside that loop. So let's have a look. We run the program. So we go through, you can see the first color. We'll check in that it should be blue on the first loop. There we go. So we have blue and that moves to ordered colors. Now we'll go through again. You can see first color, purple, green, red. Okay, green. Now it's going through the third time. We have orange. Now we can see the first color changing every time it goes through a loop. The word in programming is iterates through the loop. And you can see it's getting faster because we have less items in colors. But now we have our ordered colors list with the colors in order. So we can try that again. You can see we go through each item 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So that's the number of the item in the list. And the item in the list, in this case colors, chooses the first one, the lowest one, beginning with B. First one alphabetically, which will be blue. And then it will go through the others and choose the lowest. So we loop through the colors, find the lowest, and then we loop through it again, find the next lowest, and we carry on. So we have a loop that's inside a loop, and that gives us our ordered colors. So you can see we have a repeat block inside another repeat block. So here's our final blocks. You can see we have the repeat that we've found the first color, that's inside the outside repeat block that loops through until all of the colors are moved to the ordered colors. Thank you for watching, and we hope you enjoyed that video. If you have any suggestions or requests, then please let us know in the comments, give us a like, and if you haven't already, please subscribe. If you want to receive notifications, click on that bell as well. Okay, goodbye for now.